Okay, everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is a brand new figure review on the Star Wars, a Star Wars story, a Solo, movie Qi'ra figure. She is from the new Solo movie about Han Solo in his younger days, and we really don't know a whole lot about her character. She is played by, Emilia Clarke. We all know Emilia's, Daenerys in Game of Thrones. I love Daenerys. She's my favorite character in that show. So I'm really excited to see her in a Star Wars movie. I always imagine Emilia Clarke in a Star Wars movie. Don't know who she would play, but I always kind of pictured her in one. So she is now, and I'm glad to see her a part of one. I think she is like Han's girlfriend before Leia or something. But anyways, I did get the figure thanks to Corey. He picked her up for me the other day. My Walmart finally got new Star Wars figures in the yellow line right here, with the yellow wording. My Walmart usually sucks. Things just sit on the pegs and no one gets it. So there were a couple new figures. She was one. There was the repack Luke. There was the K2SO Maz Kanata, which I did want to get, and I think a couple other ones. So it was nice to see new figures, but once I went back there yesterday again, they were gone. Someone had already got her, so I'm glad that I was able to get her. I quite like these packaging. I like the image there, and just I got word and just today I just got news that there will be some new figures. Now this one is a repack, but he was one of my favorite characters in Force Awakens and Last Jedi, and it is Supreme Leader Snoke. It is the same figure as I have here. It's from the BB-8 playset. I got this figure because I didn't want to wait for the this figure to be repacked, but he is. It's pretty much the same figure, but look at that card back. That image is amazing. So I do want to get him to keep carded. If I do get him, I won't open him, obviously. And then we get a new Hoth Leia, and this is just her in the five point of articulation line, but I think she looks pretty good. Very nice image there, and being a huge Leia fan, I definitely am going to get her. So pretty excited for Snoke and Leia there. They're must have for my collection. So let's go ahead and take a look at the packaging. So so the Star Wars logo is in yellow for the Solo movie. We get a very nice image of Emilia Clarke as Qi'ra there. Some yellow behind her. There's her name. Now on Wikipedia, they spelled it like K-E-R-I-A or something like that. But then they changed it to Qi'ra, so it's Qi'ra. Then there's the figure, shows what she can do with the new Force Link, and I have the old Force Link, so I'm gonna see if that works with her, and that's really it. I wish they put a bio or something, but that's okay. So what I'm gonna do is spend some time and get Qi'ra out of the packaging. And we are back with Qi'ra out of the packaging, and she's a small figure. She is a female, so she's a small figure, but I think she's a pretty nicely done figure. Now, in the trailer, I just watched the new trailer. She has pretty different looks. She kind of reminds me of Padme, having a different outfit every time she walks through the door. But in one scene, she's in, like, a black dress. Her hair's long. Another scene, she has, like, a ponytail. Then she has this hairstyle. So, not sure what's up with that. But I'm looking forward to finding out more of her character in Solo, A Star Wars Story. I hope she doesn't get the Jyn Erso treatment. And when I say that, I hope she doesn't die. like Jyn Erso did in Rogue One. I was pretty upset when that happened. You know, I get the characters aren't in the OT, but you don't always have to kill them off. You can just say maybe they just went off somewhere, and yeah, but so I'm hoping she doesn't get that treatment. So yeah, so let's go ahead and take a look at this figure. And also to let you know, there is a 6-inch version of the same figure in the same outfit. I haven't seen that figure yet, or otherwise I would have probably got her. But I have the 3-inch here to show you. So here, her articulation is a ball-jointed head, swivel shoulders, swivel hips, and that's it. So basic 5-point articulation. She has a pretty good sculpt. She does kind of remind me of a Han Solo, like something, you know, a Han Solo style would wear or something like that. Right here, you can see her jacket. You can take her jacket off, it seems like, but her sleeve will be, it would just be her sleeve, as you can see, and that wouldn't make much sense. But very nicely sculpted fur right there, as well as the jacket is on the arms, and nice, you can see the wrinkles and stuff. She has a red and black shirt on. She has a some kind of bracelet right there, not sure what that is. Another bracelet right there. Oh, and she has swivel in the arms. I forgot to show you that. And they come off really easily for some reason. I mean, you can plug them back in, but... And then she kind of has this, like, skirt thing on over pants. And it's nicely sculpted. It's a two-part. It's soft rubber, and you can see the wrinkles, and it looks like snow or something. Maybe it's just part of her skirt, and then you got these two little things sticking out. And then she just has black pants on underneath. And then she has some boots on. And it looks like they have a heel on. And she does have the Force Link symbol on. Now, this, it's green. It's not like the blue one, as you can see, so I'm still hoping it will work with the normal one. We're going to test it out in a minute. And then she has nicely sculpted hair. It's kind of a short hairstyle. Like I said, she has a couple of different hairstyles in the movie. And then the face sculpt, I think, is a pretty good likeness to Emilia Clarke. I think it does really look like her. They did a good job getting that down, which is hard for Hasbro sometimes, because they don't always get female head sculpts down right away, which is a shame, but it's still pretty cool. Here is the only accessory. She comes with a blaster, and it's just a little blaster. The only color it is, it's just a gray silver color, but it's nicely sculpted. And that can be placed in our hand, like so. And we don't know anything about this character yet, but I only can assume this is her weapon that she will probably use throughout the movie. Unfortunately, she doesn't have a holster or anything to place it in, so it's either put it in a, have her hold it, or put it next to her, or put it, pack it away. So obviously I'm gonna have mine holding it, because I don't want to lose it. But yeah, so so we are gonna actually go into the Force Link, and I will be right back and do that. Oops, as she falls. So I wanted just to show you the Qi'ra figure next to a Daenerys figure. It would probably make more sense to show you her next to a, the 6-inch Qi'ra, but since I don't have her yet, at least, I'm just gonna show her next to the 3-inch, because they're both played by Emilia Clarke, and, I just want to really kind of just focus on the face sculpts, because they are different companies and different figures, but... I think Hasbro got the face sculpt down better. I think it looks more like Emilia Clarke on the Qi'ra figure. Yeah, I definitely think the Hasbro face sculpt is better. This does resemble her to some extent, but not a whole lot in my opinion. But yeah, I just wanted to show the face sculpts, so yeah. If I get the 6-inch version of the Qi'ra figure, I definitely will do a comparison with the Daenerys figure as well. So, even though this is not the new Han Solo figure, I wanted to show you her next to a Han Solo figure. This is the Han Solo figure that came with the Jabba from Power of the Force, and even though Harrison Ford does not play Han in this movie, they do look pretty nice together. As you can tell, the difference between the Han and the Qi'ra figure, you can tell the Qi'ra figure is more modern and more detailed, while the Power of the Force Han here isn't as detailed, and it looks more a little more cartoony, if anything. But I did want to show her next to a Han figure, and they seem like they're actually in good scale. I mean, Han is supposed to be a taller, but yeah, I do think they look pretty good together. I might get the new Han Solo figure if I see one down the road, but right now I'm okay with just Qi'ra. I want to see the movie first before I get any more of the characters. So, yeah. And really fast, I just wanted to welcome Qi'ra into the Star Wars, Ladies of Star Wars, the leading ladies. Even though Rose isn't really the leading lady of the sequel trilogy or Last Jedi, she's more of a supporting character. I just decided to add her in there anyway. But we have Padme, Jen, Leia, and Rey, and then Rose. So I'm hoping that Qi'ra here will also be a good addition to these strong, badass women. I'm hoping a Skywalker appears in the Solo movie, whether it's Darth Vader or someone, you know, because at the end of the day, Star Wars, the main saga has always been about the Skywalker family. Like Rogue One, Leia, and Vader appeared, and they weren't in the movie long, but it was still a nice nod to the Skywalker story. I really hope Qi'ra is a good add to that. I'm looking forward to see her in the movie, and I'm glad to welcome her into the Ladies of Star Wars line here. So, all in all, I quite like this figure. Even though she's a small figure, she is still nicely sculpted, and I think she does look a lot like the character from what we've seen, and I think, she does have really nicely, done details and stuff like that, and I'm really looking forward to seeing who her character is and what kind of part she played in Han's life and stuff like that. So let me know if you like this figure. Let me know if you're looking forward to seeing her in the movie. Let me know if you plan to get any of the new figures from the Solo movie. And let me know if you're excited to see the movie in general. That's gonna do it for this video. Let me know your thoughts down below. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask. And all my information is, as always, is down below. And until my next video, I'll see you guys later. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day. Bye. Oh, you just enjoy your time, Qi'ra. But I will be coming. What do you mean? Oh, you don't want to know? I thought you already knew. Han Solo is my man. He is my man. He won't be yours, because I'm sure you will die like Jen Erso did, who didn't even give me the plan. Death Star plans herself. So you enjoy Han right now, and in the original trilogy, in a couple years, I will be with him. Excuse me. I didn't mean to die, by the way. No one asked you, Jen. So enjoy your time. Dun dun dun. Okay, you guys made it to the end of the video. Thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Remember, you guys can follow me on the social media links I have in my channel and down below. And I also do have a fan mail address. If you would like to send fan mail, feel free to do so. And I hope you guys enjoyed this review. Please subscribe to my channel and have a great day.